On June 1st, 1215, the city of Chengdu, known today as Beijing, fell to the Mongols. They looted the city, sending caravans loaded with luxuries back home. This victory over the Qin dynasty was to be one of Genghis Khan's greatest triumphs. After his death in 1227, his descendants continued the conquests. And his grandson, Batu Khan, had his eyes on the West. The Mongol raids of the 1220s had shown that the Rus lands held riches worth exploiting. The battles had devastated the Rus elite, and their defenses were weak. So Batu Khan organized an enormous invasion force, determined to turn the Rus lands into vassals of the Mongol Empire. The Mongols captured territory after territory. By 1240, they had their sights on the great city of Kiev. Kiev was a jewel among the Rus principalities, a center of scholarship, power, and wealth. Batu Khan's cousin Monka was put in command of the advance force, ready to attack. Chroniclers tell of Monka's admiration for the beauty of Kiev, so he was reluctant to destroy it. Monka sent his envoys to the city to demand its surrender. But Kiev's commander in charge refused and killed the Mongol envoys. Monka would not stand for such disrespect. His army rode to the city walls and prepared to attack. They would show Kiev no mercy. Monke Khan's drive into the west brought the Mongol army to the splendid city of Kiev, the gateway to Europe. The Kievan commander had refused to surrender, leaving Monke only one choice, to take the city by force.
Ha ha ha!
The Mongol army broke through the gates of Kiev and marched on the city. Mongke Khan called on his people to bring in their mobile camp, while his forces secured a location for it. The Mongols unpacked their camp, ready to continue their assault on Kiev. The immediate area beyond Kiev's main gate was lightly populated, but rich in resources. Beyond lay three fortified districts: the outer city, the inner city, and a wealthy trade district. The Khan was determined to punish the defiance of Kiev, and would not relent until the entire city fell to ash.
Ich tut geht, weißt du? Амар байна уу? Би гişü авчирсан.
Эхэй, бахтай ба.
Дэрөө махан авчирсан. Танд юу хийх вэ? Би үүнийг барайх гэсэн.
Анхааралтай сонор.
The Mongols took out a Kiev and supply convoy and claimed the resources for themselves.
Come on, come on, come on!
Thank you.
주제 어쩌죠? 이 안발등이 없고 최소
소속 총괄!
바다 나도와 함께 없어. 베딩데 도시가 자꾸 보리치. 어디?
제메구이 안도와 잭사 답한 거이 아리 호마르다 엽소와 미구스소
샤디 가이드다. 토니 키모이.
바로 잠다 옆모이.
토샤 대추다. 옆소.
토샤 대후야 비 토샤 대후디노이.
에이비디 다른 곳 좀 봐야 보이.
오기도 토 애를 크게 봤다. 남도 봐요. 고치트가이. 샤디 폭도 못한소
The unstoppable Mongol army leveled the trade district of Kiev, putting an end to any supplies they could send to the main city.
Шаад болгох цаг бол бай. Анхаар чэрэглэн алх бүтэлмүү тамтид. Залхуу гүрэн чит хөдөл. You hit it, stick boy. Beat and bird you so. Хэрэгтэй. Уран барьсан байм уу?
ажиллах цаг боллоо. Гөрөөлх үе сайхан бүлгөө.
Юу хийж эмсдэх бой? Бидний бодлого барай дуусгасуу. Хэрэгтэй
бүү. Амьд үгүй хүний гэрлэг аваасаа.
Албарлаж дуусгасан. Шаф ичээсү. Барьж дуусчихгүй сайхан харагдмаа. Юу хийж эцлэх бой?
Цугаар анхааралтай байна уу? Ажиллах цаг боллоо.
Тушаан буулгах цаг бол бай. Хөдөл туулах зам бүр. Анхаарахгүй. Хийх ажил байгүй. Чэргэлэн ах, бүтэл муу тамтид. Үнийг хийж дуусгамай. Өгөр чулуу харуур үслэлтийн хороо хөдлөмүй. Галтай шатаагч сайн байгүй.
Ушаадыг анхааралтай хүлээ. Ажиллаж байгүй.
Цугаар бэлэн байгүй. За. Би биш.
Одгоч ном бэлэн хүлээмгүй. Би барьж баймгүй.
Ажил дууслаа. Бэлтгэдэггүй. Тушаал хүлээ.
Ажил дууслаа.
Арваа чид бэлтээ. Барь юу?
Шатар гişүү төвлөө.
Атри хороо билэг. Хамсдхой яа бэлэн боллоо. Шатайг бүгд дугуй дагсуу.
Ама. Хочад дэнди хэрвэл байгүй.
Байдаг юм шиг.
Эрчүүд, эрчүүд.
Тушада хуя бетин. Гад сумавда.
Oh, I'm going to go ahead. Oh, I'm going to go ahead. анхаарахгүй юу дүн бий вэ? Хөдөл.
Эрчүүдээ бидний тушаалаа.
Би бүх дуугүй тагсуу.
Шат
юу аа? Чад хэрэг эдэн баймой.
Анхаарах туй тушаал сонс.
Юунд үлбэв бэ? Хөдөл.
The horde devastated the outer city.
도샤도 그끄지 마이 무이
As the last buildings collapsed, the Mongol victory was complete. Kiev had fallen. Monka Khan and his Mongol warriors ran freely through the ravaged city, cutting down any survivors and plundering its riches. With Kiev under Mongol control, the gateway to Europe was open, and the empire could continue its conquest into the West.
Yeah.